Today we're taking a look at these NHL matches, which are happening on Tuesday, January 10, 2023, and giving you our team picks for today. Welcome back to High Stakes. Before we dive into our video, don't forget to subscribe and push that notification bell to get notified as soon as we release these sport prediction videos, and make sure to watch it till the end so you don't miss any of our picks. Also check out our Patreon if you want access our premium picks. Our Patreon is a way for us to help you improve your chances of making more money. You will find the link in description and comment section below. One more thing before we start, check out our new channel High Stakes Props and Parlays, where you can find our player props and parlay picks predictions. You will find the link in the description and comment section below. Seattle has been a dominant team on the road this season, with a 12-4-2 road record, while Buffalo is a decent 8-8-2 at home this year. These defenses have shown a large difference as of late, with Seattle allowing 2 goals in their previous 4 games, while Buffalo is giving up 3.6 goals in their last 5 games. I was initially leaning towards the Sabres at home here, but while one game doesn't define a team, it certainly dealt a blow to my confidence in the Sabres coming into this game. If everything was level and both teams won on Monday, I'd give the edge to Buffalo because they're the hotter team and didn't have to travel. However, now with Buffalo losing on Monday while Seattle kept the momentum going, our team pick is Seattle Kraken money line. All in all, go with the Seattle Kraken to go on the road and pick up a win here. Pittsburgh Penguins versus Vancouver Canucks. I get the case to be made on either side in this game, but I'm backing the Penguins minus 1.5 here. This just feels like a solid get-right spot for the Pens after a bit of a rough patch lately, as they're the better team in my opinion. The Canucks have lost 4 of their last 5 games, and 3 of their last 4 road games. They usually play well offensively, but they're struggling at the moment, scoring 14 goals in their last 5 games. They have played well on special teams, converting over 24% of their power play opportunities. Unfortunately for them, the Penguins are great at killing penalties, and they play well defensively at home, holding opponents under 3 goals per game, so expect them to keep Vancouver's offense in check. The Penguins have also struggled in recent games, but they've played well at home, where they have won 6 of their last 9 games. They continue to play well offensively, scoring more than 3 goals per game at home. They have also played well on special teams, converting more than 20% of their power play opportunities. Our team pick is Pittsburgh Penguins minus 1.5 goals. The Canucks are terrible at killing penalties, and they have struggled defensively on the road, giving up more than 3.5 goals per game, so expect them to have a hard time slowing down the Penguins in this game. Go with Pittsburgh to cover the puck line. Carolina Hurricanes versus New Jersey Devils. 3 consecutive defeats bring the Carolina Hurricanes, first in Metropolitan Division, to a domestic outing against the New Jersey Devils, second in Metropolitan, who have won just 4 of their past 14 fixtures. The Hurricanes are 5-0 in the last 5 games against New Jersey. Carolina has fared well against the Devils when playing at home. The Hurricanes are 7-1 in their last 8 home games against New Jersey. In the last 10 meetings between these two teams, Carolina averages 3.70 goals per game, and New Jersey averages 2.90 goals per game. The Devils have struggled a bit lately, going 4-10 in their last 14 games, while Carolina has been hot lately, going 15-4 in their last 19 games. Defense and goaltending have both been fantastic for Carolina this season. They rank 6th in goals against per game, and 1st in shots against per game. Peter Kachekov has a record of 10-3-4 with a 2.20 GA and .919 SB percent. The New Jersey Devils have been road warriors this season, so there's certainly some value with them in the underdog role. However, the Carolina Hurricanes have been one of the best teams in the league over the last 3 weeks, and they've been a buzzsaw at home dating back to last year. The Canes are also due for a bounce-back win after 3 straight losses. Can make a case for either side. This one, essentially, is a clash between the 2 best teams in the Metropolitan Division at the moment. The edge, though, firmly lies with the Hurricanes here. The Devils arguably carry the best road record in the whole league, 14-1, but have been so inconsistent lately that they have failed to follow up a victory with another win on the past 4 occasions, going with just 4 triumphs in their previous 14 matchups overall. New Jersey has also failed to beat the Canes in any of their last 5 head-to-head clashes, losing each of its most recent 4 trips to North Carolina. Our team pick is Carolina Hurricanes money line. The Hurricanes, meanwhile, have posted a whopping 42 victories in their past 57 domestic outings, going 9-2 in their previous 11 games against teams from the Eastern Conference. New York Rangers vs. Minnesota Wild. The Minnesota Wild, 22-14-3, 47 points, 3rd Central, pay a visit to the Big Apple and Madison Square Garden on Tuesday for an NHL showdown with the New York Rangers, 22-12-7, 51 points, 3rd Metro. Minnesota lost to the St. Louis Blues on Sunday 3-0 and has lost two straight. New York was defeated by the New Jersey Devils 4-3 on Saturday. The loss snapped a 3-game winning streak for the Rangers. Marc-Andre Fleury, Jordan Greenway and Matt Zuccarello are all questionable. Johnny Brodzinski is out for the Rangers. The New York Rangers have been red hot as of late, led by elite seasons thus far from their three best skaters, and with the advantage in all three units over Minnesota, they understandably come into this one as big favorites. The New York Rangers are playing above average on both ends of the ice, scoring 3.24 goals per game, which is 13th, and allowing 2.71 goals per game, which is 7th. New York has won 5 of its last 6 played on its home ice, and the Rangers have won 11 of the last 15 overall. Minnesota has lost 2 straight entering this matchup in 3 of its last 5. The Wild may be without their top goalie Marc-Andre Fleury, who has won 6 of his last 9 starts in net, but missed the most recent game for Minnesota due to a personal matter, and is questionable for Tuesday. The Minnesota Wild are worth a look in the underdog role, because they're an above-average team you don't often get at these prices. However, the New York Rangers appear to be back on track, they're at home, and their defensive effort is probably the difference in this game. Probably a low-scoring contest, but I trust the Rangers' goalies to squeeze out a tight win. Our team pick is New York Rangers minus 1.5 goals. New York goalie Igor Shesterkin has won 8 of his last 12 starts, and 2 of the 4 losses were in either overtime or a shootout, when he allowed 3 goals and 1 goal in regulation in the 2 games. Tampa Bay Lightning vs. Columbus Blue Jackets. The Columbus Blue Jackets face the Tampa Bay Lightning, with both teams heading in opposite directions this season. The Blue Jackets have a 12-25-2 record, and with only 2 wins in their last 10 games, have fallen to last place in the Metropolitan Division. The Lightning have a 24-13-1 record and are in 3rd place in the Atlantic Division, but look to bounce back from consecutive losses. Both teams are looking to improve from rough losses and gain ground in their divisions, and the upcoming game should be a good one as a result. I get the case to be made for a team like Columbus, just because of the heavy plus money attached, but I can't back Columbus themselves, just because the Blue Jackets are an absolute mess from top to bottom. The Blue Jackets are looking to pull off the upset on the road, but the Lightning have looked like one of the best teams in the Eastern Conference, and look to control this game from the opening puck drop. The Lightning, who average 3.47 goals per game, should constantly find the back of the net against the Blue Jackets, who allow 3.87 goals per game, with Nikita Kucherov, Steven Stamkos, and the rest of the forward unit carrying the puck into the offensive zone and creating open shots with quick passes to the face-off circles and the slot. The Lightning should also limit a Blue Jackets offense that has scored only 6 goals in the last 4 games, with Mikhail Sergachev, Victor Hedman, and the rest of the defensive unit forcing turnovers in the neutral zone and defensive zone, while goaltender Andrei Vasilevsky blanks the shots on the net. The Tampa Bay Lightning have the edge over most teams in the league, but the Blue Jackets especially, and with a 5-0 record in their last 5 in Tampa Bay, as well as a 7-1 record in their past 8 overall, this is a team that is playing at an all-time level against Columbus. Our team pick is Lightning minus 1.5 goals. The Lightning should win the game and cover the spread with a strong performance on their home ice. Detroit Red Wings vs. Winnipeg Jets. The Jets are on a dominant run right now and look to continue their winning streak on the road tonight in Detroit. The Red Wings have shown good signs at points this season, but are struggling recently. The puck drops tonight in this cross-conference matchup at Little Caesars Arena in Detroit. The Winnipeg Jets are coming off a strong week, and they've absolutely feasted on losing reams dating back to last season. The Detroit Red Wings have issues finishing games, and their defensive effort isn't getting any better. The Red Wings also have issues winning at home. I give the Jets a very significant edge in this game tonight and expect them to get a big win on the road. Winnipeg is a great team this season on both ends of the ice. Their defense is elite and has been one of the top 2 in the league, backstopped by a top-tier goaltender in Connor Hellebuyck. I expect them to be able to shut down a Red Wings offense that has struggled all season. The Red Wings are looking to win on their home ice, but the Jets are having a great season, and I see them controlling this game from the first period. The Jets, who average 3.30 goals per game, should find the back of the net at will against a Red Wings defense that has allowed 12 goals in the last three games, with Kyle Connor, Pierre-Luc Dubois, and the rest of the forward unit establishing a strong offensive zone presence and creating open shots with great puck movement. The Jets, who allow only 2.58 goals per game, should also limit the Red Wings' offense, which is scoring only 2.97 goals per game, with Josh Morrissey, Dylan DeMello, and the rest of the defensive unit creating turnovers in the defensive zone and limiting shots on the net, while goaltender Connor Hellebuyck blanks the shots on the goal. Our team pick is Jets money line. The Jets should win the game with a decisive victory on the road. New York Islanders vs. Dallas Stars. The Dallas Stars face the New York Islanders with both teams looking to build off of strong seasons. The Stars have a 24-11-6 record, which is the best in the Central Division, while the Islanders have a 22-17-2 record and are in the middle of the Metropolitan Division, but look to bounce back from back-to-back losses. Both teams look to improve within their conferences, and the upcoming game should be a great one as a result. I get the case to be made for either side in this game, but I like the Islanders at home here. The Dallas Stars aren't going to win every game, and the home team has won the last five meetings between these two teams. New York's been playing their better hockey at home all year long, and I think in this one that's the case as well. This is going to be a great game between two teams eager to improve in the standings. The Stars are having a great season and look to win on the road, but the Islanders look to bounce back from two rough losses and control this game. The Islanders, who average 3.15 goals per game, should constantly find the back of the net with Matthew Barzal, Brock Nelson, and the rest of the forward unit carrying the puck into the offensive zone and creating open shots with great puck movement, while Noah Dobson generates shots on the net from the blue line. The Islanders also look to rebound after allowing four goals and limiting the Stars' offense with Ryan Pulock, Alexander Romanov, and the rest of the defensive unit creating turnovers in the defensive zone and limiting shots on the net, allowing goaltender Ilya Sorokin to make plenty of big saves. Our team pick is Islanders money line. The Islanders should win the game with a strong performance on their home ice. St. Louis Blues vs. Calgary Flames. The Calgary Flames face the St. Louis Blues, with both teams looking to improve from rocky seasons. The Flames have a 19-14-8 record and are in fourth place in the Pacific Division, while the Blues have a 20-18-3 record and are in the middle of the Central Division. Both teams are looking to improve in the Western Conference and jump into playoff position, and the upcoming game should be a great one as a result. While the Blues have a solid record against Calgary in the past few seasons, they're currently dealing with several massive injuries, and given how important this road trip is to the season of the Flames, they'll come out firing in this one. This is going to be a great game between two evenly matched teams. The Blues are looking to win on their home ice, but the Flames look to find favorable matchups on both ends of the ice. The Flames should pile on the goals with Nazem Kadri, Tyler Toffoli, and the rest of the forward unit, controlling the puck in the offensive zone and creating open shots with great puck movement. The Flames, who allow only 2.93 goals per game and have only allowed 12 goals in the last five games, should limit the Blues' offense with Rasmus Andersson, Noah Hanifin, and the rest of the defensive unit, creating turnovers in the defensive zone and limiting shots on the net, allowing goaltender Jacob Markstrom to make plenty of big saves. Our team pick is Flames money line. The Flames should win the game with a strong performance on the road. Arizona Coyotes vs. San Jose Sharks. San Jose and Arizona lock horns for the second time this season. Back in December, the Sharks outlasted the Coyotes 3-2 as -170 home favorites, with a total of 6.0 goals. San Jose is a -130 road fave this time around, while the totals are listed at 6.5 goals. The Arizona Coyotes aren't playing good hockey and aren't a team you should be eager to back. However, similar things can be said about the San Jose Sharks. At least we're getting the Coyotes at home and the plus money. If forced to pick between two struggling teams, well, the Coyotes have lost five in a row. Four of those games were on the road, and on the season, they are over .500 on home ice. They have good home underdog value in this game at home, where they have won four in a row over the Sharks. San Jose has given up 9 goals in their last 2 games, and both of their goalies have struggled as of late. Arizona has only scored 3 goals in their last 3 games, and while they will not light up the scoreboard in this one, their attack will be pretty good. Their defense will not play great, but be decent against a San Jose team that scored just 2 goals in their last game. It's hard to predict the outcome when a couple of awful teams take on each other. Both San Jose and Arizona have struggled a lot over the last 10 days, and it seems impossible to make the case for either side. I'm going with the Yotes at plus money only because they'll have strong support from the stands. Also, Karol Vejmelka has done a decent job so far this season, and could make a difference. The Coyotes have won 6 of their last 9 games at home, including a couple of impressive 6-3 victories over the Colorado Avalanche and Toronto Maple Leafs. Our team pick is Arizona Coyotes for the win. On the other side, the Sharks have only won 2 of their previous 9 games on the road. San Jose is winless in 4 straight road tilts against Arizona. Florida meets Colorado for the first time this season. They split a 2-game set in 2021-22, and each team emerged victorious at home. The Avalanche open as -135 moneyline favorites, while the totals are listed at 6.5 goals. I get the case to be made either way in this game, but I'm sticking with the Avs here. Colorado finally showed some resolve in rallying to beat Edmonton in their last game, and while the Florida Panthers have had wins here and there, the reality is that they're still not a very good road team. The Panthers are coming off a blowout loss, while the Avalanche snapped their 5-game skid in their last game. While the underdog is 6-2 in the last 8 games between these teams, I am going to buck that trend. Florida has lost their last 5 games facing teams with a winning record, and in their last 3 games facing teams over .500, they have been outscored 14-4. Colorado's offense has not gotten it done on the season or in the last few games. They will be decent in this game, but their defense will play well facing a Florida team that only scored 1 goal in their last game. The Panthers have been inconsistent all season. They are 3-6 in the last 9 games overall, and 1-4 in the last 5 outings on the road. The Panthers own a lot of dangerous offensive weapons, but their defense is far away from an elite level. Also, the Panthers are tallying 11.9 penalty minutes per game, enough for the 3rd most in the NHL. On the other side, the Avs have defended well for most of the season, but they've yielded 25 goals over their last 6 outings. After holding the Oilers' mighty offense to just 2 goals, the Avs will be fired up to stay on the right track, and their offense will have a nice opportunity to improve in a favorable matchup against Florida. Our team pick is Colorado for the win. On home ice, the Avs will get the W and hand the Panthers their 2nd loss in a row.